warm wishes to one another. Myself, my name is Sai Kiran. I am IIT faculty from Velamar. Today's our topic is trigonometry. It was introduced by Hipparchus. Okay, trigonometry is derived from two Greek words. One is trigona, another one is metron. Trigona means triangle, metron means measurement. That means trigonometry is totally meaning triangle measurement. Okay, next, where we can use trigonometry? That means applications of trigonometry. When you construct a buildings or flyovers or some electrical circuits, we can use trigonometry. Before going to this chapter, we need to discuss about angle, system of measurement of angles, and relationship between the radians and degrees, and depends upon the system of measurements, we can say the relationship between the three system. In this system of measurement of angle, we have a three system of measurement of an angles. What is meant by an angle? If you take an initial ray, this is initial ray, it was rotated somewhat, some amount of rotation occurs here, that is called an angle. Here some amount of rotation occur, that is called an angle. Okay, next, note here the rotation is in anti-clockwise direction. For example, here initial ray and it is rotated anti-clockwise direction, then we can call that this is positive angle. Positive angle. When you take the rotation is in clockwise direction, for example, this is clockwise direction, then it is negative angle. Next, magnitude of an angle. For example, if you take an angle, for example, this is only OA is initial ray and OB is, it is rotation occur, that means it is reflected, then it is called reflected ray. OA is initial ray, OB is reflected ray. How we can measure, how we can remember? Okay, we can write angle is in between A, O, B or B, O, A. That means we can write angle A, O, B or angle B, O, A. We can represent either angle A, O, B or angle B, O, A. Next, system of measurement of an angle. What is system of measurement of an angle? For example, if you are going to somewhat distance, means how much of distance we travel, that means either we can say 10 centimeter or 10 meter or 100 kilometer, that is measurement we are saying with different units. In the same way, angle you can measure in different units. Okay, here system of measurement of angle. In this, three systems are there. First one is sexagesimal system or English system. In this system, the unit of measurement of an angle is degree. Unit is degree. Okay, what is this? Okay, when you take the complete angle, what is meant by complete angle? For example, rotation occur, here some rotation occur means this is an angle. Complete rotation means complete rotation over. That means this is complete angle. Here, when you take a here, it is a complete angle. The complete angle can be divided into 360 equal parts. The complete angle can be divided into 360 equal parts. Okay, for example, here it is divided into 360 equal parts. Each part, this part is called degree. Okay, it divided into 360 equal parts. Each part is called degree. We can say that on one more thing. Okay, for example, here it is a cake. It divided into 4 equal parts. Each part is 1/4. Okay, it divided into 6 equal parts. Each part is 1/6. In the same way, here the complete angle can be divided into 360 equal part. Each part is 1/360. That means 1/360th part of complete angle. Complete angle is called degree. Is called degree. What is meant by degree in this sexagesimal system means 1/360th part of complete angle is called degree. Overall, what we can say, the complete angle can be divided into 360 equal part. Each part is called degree. Next, by using this one, we can say one thing. Yeah, in this system, the complete angle means how many degrees? 360 degrees. Okay. Next, in this only, for example, here, what is meant by degree? We got it. Next. In this continuation, what is meant by minute? Minute in sexagesimal system. Okay. Sexagesimal system. Okay, you told what is meant by degree means? Okay, complete angle can be divided into 360 equal part. Each part is called degree. Okay, here in the same way, for example, here it is degree. Okay, this degree can be again divided into 60 equal parts. 60 equal parts. Again divided into 60 equal parts. This is, each part is called minute. Each part is called minute. Okay, here what is degree means? Complete angle can be divided into 360 equal parts. Each part is called degree. If we here, each degree can be divided into 60 equal parts. Each part is called minute. Okay. How we can denote minute means 1/dash. Here it is 1 minute. If you are taking two parts, it is 2/dash. That means 2 minutes. Okay. Sorry to say, here 1 degree can be denoted by 1/. We are writing 0. We are looking like a 0. That means it is nothing but 1 degree. 1 part means 1 degree. 2 parts we are taking means 2 degrees. Understood? In the same way, minute. Sorry. Seconds. Seconds. What is second in this system? Okay. In the same way, here 1 minute. We are taking this is in this part 1 minute we are taking. Here it is 1 minute. Again, 1 minute can be divided into 60 equal parts. Again, 1 minute can be divided into 60 equal parts. Each part is called second. Okay, it can be denoted by 1/[dash]. That means 1 second. If you are taking 2 parts, means it will 2/[dash]. That means 2 seconds. Okay, that means what do you understand? Here it is the complete angle means 360 degrees. Okay, in that 1 part we are taking means that is 1 degree. Okay, here. 1 minute means here the degree can be divided into 60 equal part. Each part is minute. Okay, here 1 second means if you are taking 1 minute, it divided into again 60 equal parts. Each part is called second. Okay, and what do you observe here? 1 degree can be divided into 60 equal part. Each part is minute means 1 degree means how many minutes means 60 minutes. 60 minutes. That means in the same way, 1 minute can be divided into 60 equal parts. That means each part is second means 1 minute is equal to how many seconds? 1 minute is equal to how many seconds? 60 seconds. 60 seconds. Okay, by using this one, we can say, just see here once of the 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. 60 minutes can be converted into second means. Again, 1 minute means 60 seconds now. That means 60 into 60 seconds. That means it can be written as 1 degree is nothing but 3600 seconds. By using this one, what you can say? 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, then 1 minute is equal to 1 by 60 degrees. In the same way, here 1 degree is equal to 3600 seconds. That means 1 second is equal to 1 by 3600 degrees. 1 second is equal to how many degrees means? 1 by 3600 degrees. Okay. Next. Okay. What is meant by right angle means when you take the complete angle, for example, here it is complete angle. Complete angle can be divided into 4 equal parts. 4 equal parts. Each part is called right angle. We can call as right angle. When you observe nothing but one side, here it is complete angle. When you divide with 4 equal parts means angle between them is 90. Nothing but right angle we are getting or not. Okay, each part is called right angle. That means complete angle is nothing but 360 degrees. Each part is how much we are getting means 90 degrees. That means in this system, one right angle is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, just here in this system again we can discuss. Okay, the complete angle can be divided into 360 equal parts. Each part is called degree. Again, each degree divided into 60 equal parts, each part is called minute. Again, each minute can be divided into 60 equal parts, each part is called second. Okay, here the complete angle can be divided into 4 equal parts, each part is called right angle. That means 1 right angle is equal to 90 degrees in this system. Okay, which system? Sexagesimal system or our English system. Next one is centesimal system. Centesimal system. Okay, what is centesimal system means? Same thing. What we can do means, here the complete angle, for example, this is complete angle. This complete angle can be divided into 400 equal parts. 400 equal parts. 400 equal parts. Each part is called grade. Sorry to say, here the unit of measurement of an angle is grade. Here the unit of measurement of an angle is grade. Here the complete angle can be divided into 400 equal parts. Each part is called grade. Okay. In this also minute. Okay. Sorry. Here grade can be denoted by 1 power z. That means here each part is we are calling as 1 grade. That means 1 power z. That is nothing but 1 grade. Understood. Next, in the same way, here also you have a minute and second. What is meant by minute means each grade, for example, if you are taking here it is grade. Each grade can be divided into 100 equal parts. 100 equal parts. Okay, each part is called minute. Representation of minute is 1 power dash nothing but here it is looking like a before system only, but both are not equal. Both are not equal. In the same way, here also we have a second. What is that second means? Each minute, again we are taking this is 1 minute, for example. This is 1 minute. It can be divided into again 100 equal parts. 100 equal parts. Each part is called second. Second. It can be denoted by 1 power double dash. Okay, that means here 1 second representation before system, 1 second representation will be same, but both are not same. Okay, that means here, what is difference between before and here means, before system that can be divided into 360 equal parts, here it can be divided into 400 equal parts. Before one, each part is called degree, here each part is called grade. And next one, okay, before system we are divided into 60 equal parts. Okay, here it is divided into 100 equal parts. 100 equal parts, that means here, 1 grade can be divided into 100 equal parts means 1 minute. Sorry. 1 grade can be divided into 100 equal parts means here it is nothing but 1 grade is equal to 100 minutes. In the same way, 1 minute, again it is divided into 100 equal parts. That means 1 minute is equal to 100 seconds. In the same way, before we told, 1 grade is equal to how many seconds? That means 100 into 100, that is nothing but 10,000 seconds. 1 grade is equal to how many seconds? Means 10,000 seconds. Okay. In the same way here, what is one right angle? The complete angle can be divided into 4 equal parts, means each part is here. Complete angle is 400 grades. 400 grades. Each part we can get. For example, here it is 400 grades divided into 4 equal parts, means each part is how much? 100 grades. That means in this system, one right angle is equal to how much? Means 100 grades. In this system, one right angle is equal to 100 grades. Next. Next one. Circular system. Circular system or a radian system. Radian system. Circular system or a radian system. Okay. What is meant by circular system or radian system? Okay. Before, those two are different and this one is different. For example, what is circular or radian? Radian. Here, in this system, unit of measurement of an angle, unit is radian. Unit is radian. Okay, what is meant by radian? What is meant by radian? For example, if we are taking a circle, nothing but complete angle, rotation is nothing but complete angle, we are discussing with our circle. For example, here it is center. Okay, we can take a radius. Okay, and we can take another radius. For example, angle between the two radius, we are getting something else now. Okay, that something else we can call as radian. When we can call as radian? Okay, for example, here it is radius r and this is also radius r only. Just here, when we can say this is a radian, means okay, once of the angle subtended by the center of the circle. Okay. The length of arc is equal to the radius. When the length of arc is equal to the radius, that means this length of arc is equal to this radius, and what the angle here subtended, this is called an radian. This is called radian. That means, for example, here radius and this radius is same, and this is also radius. Here how much angle it will be formed, that is called 1 radian. 1 radian can be denoted by 1 power c. We can read as 1 radian. Okay, what is meant by radian? Means the angle subtended the center of the circle. Okay, when we can call this is radian, means the arc formed here with the 2 radius, this arc length is equal to the radius, then what angle here it is formed, that is called radian. Okay. For example, here, if you are taking here also this is radius and this is also this arc length, also this is radius only, then here also 1 radian will be formed, then total how much angle it will be, means 2 radians. Total angle is 2 radians. In the same way, here also we can take 1 more radius and this is also radius, then total is 3 radian. In the same way, when you observe the arc of length, this is 1 radian. Okay, this is 2 radius, this is 3 radius. Okay, when we are taking 1 radius, which is equal to this radius, means 1 radian we are getting. If you are taking 2 radius, that means 2 radius length, then it will form a 2 radians. Okay, if you are taking 3 radius length, it will form a 3 radian angle. Okay, if it is formed a 4 radian, 5 end. Totally, if it is complete circle over, means circumference of a circle over how much times of radius it will be, means 2 pi r. Circumference of a circle is 2 pi r only, na? That means how many times of it is radius, means 2 pi times of radius. Okay, that means complete circle over means 2 pi times of radius over. That means complete angle how much means 2 pi radians. 2 pi radian. In this system, the complete angle is 2 pi radian. That means complete angle in this system is 2 pi radian. Okay. In this system, complete angle is 2 pi radian. Okay. Next, one right angle. Complete angle is how much? Complete angle, what we are taking? 2 pi radians. 2 pi radians. It divided into 4 equal parts. 4 equal part means complete angle can be divided into 4 equal parts. Then it will become pi by 2 radian. Pi by 2 radian. That means so one right angle in this system, circular system or radian system, is pi by 2 radians. Pi by 2. Next step. Relation between radian and degree. When you observe, okay, now only we told what is complete angle in radian system is 2 pi radians. 2 pi radians. What is complete angle in degrees means 360 degrees. That is nothing but 2 pi radians is nothing but 360 degrees. That means pi radians is equal to how much means 360 by 2 degrees. That is nothing but pi radians is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, we want to convert one radian value is how many degrees? One radian value is how many degrees means one radian is equal to, we can write 180 degrees by pi. What is pi value means we know 22 by 7. That means one radian is equal to 180 by 22 by 7. 22 by 7 we can write as here into 7. Okay, we can simplify this one, means that 2 table, here it is 11 times, here it is 90 times. 97 is 1 radian is equal to 360 by 11 degrees. 360 by 11 degrees we can convert it. We can again simplify. Or we can simplify means 1 radian is equal to 360 by 11 means 5 times 55. Remainder is 80. Here 6. Sorry. Remainder is 8, 80, 11. 7 times 77, 3 is remainder, that means 53 plus 3 by 11 degrees we can write. Then again we can rewrite as 57 degrees, it is nothing but 3 by 11 degrees. 3 by 11 degrees. Okay, now only we told 1 degree is equal to how many minutes, means 60 minutes. That means here 3 by 11 degrees. 3 by 11 degrees can be converted into minutes, means 57 degrees plus 3 into 60 by 11 minutes. That is nothing but 57 degrees 180 by 11 minutes. 180 by 11. Again 57 degrees plus, here it is 180 by 11. 1 times 11 remainder is 7. 70 means 6 times 66. Again 4 remainder, 4 by 11 minutes. Okay, again when you simplify this one, means what you are getting means 57 degrees 16 minutes plus 4 by 11 minutes. Minutes can be converted into second, means again into 60 seconds. Okay, when you simplify, rewrite as this is approximately 57 degrees 16 minutes 22 seconds. Approximately, when you simplify this one, we can get approximately 22 seconds. That means approximately we are getting this one. That means 1 radian is equal to how many degrees, means 57 degrees 16 minutes 22 seconds. Okay, in the same way we want 1 radian is equal to, sorry, 1 degree is equal to how many radians? 1 degree is equal to how many radians? 1 degree is equal to how many radians means in the same way, same thing. Here we want, 5 radians is equal to, we are getting 180 degrees. The same way 1 degree we want means 180 will send to this side means pi by 180 radian. 1 degree is equal to pi value, what we are taking? 22 by 180 into 7. When you simplify this one means approximately 0.01746 radians. Okay, that means 1 degree is equal to how many radian means? Approximately, this is also approximately 0.01746 radians. Okay, next we want to discuss about relationship between the three systems. Relationship between the three systems. Okay, how we can relationship, how we can find? Okay, for example, I will take, okay, the first system, English system. Okay, we can degrees we are taking, degrees we are taking. Second system we are taking grades, and third system we are taking radians. Radians. Okay, in the first system we are taking one right angle is 90 degrees. Okay, I am taking 90 degrees. Okay, in the second system grades, one right angle is 100 grades. In the third system, one right angle is equal to pi by 2 radians. For example, some angle which is degrees, grades, radians are equal. Okay, some angle we are taking, that is how much is there in degrees and grades are also same and radius also same. That means, okay, how much it is, that nothing but just here once again. This is one right angle, this is also one right angle, this is also one right angle. Okay, that means these three are equal only. Okay, in the same way, like that angle we are taking, three system are equal. When you divide with these two, okay, these things, by Euclidean division lemma, Euclidean's property, we can take division of these two, d by 90 is equal to g by 100 is equal to r by pi by 2. R by pi by 2, when you simply rewrite as d by 90 is equal to g by 100 is equal to 2 r by pi. Okay, this is the relationship between the three systems. Relationship between the three system, d by 90 is equal to g by 100 is equal to 2 r by pi. Why we are using this relation? Okay, for example, they are given degrees, we want to find the grades. Okay, by using these two we can take, for example, I will take 45 degrees they are given. 45 degrees we want to convert into grades. 45 degrees we are converting degrees into grades. That means we need to take only these two. Degree, d by 90 is equal to g by 100. Okay, how many degrees they are given? 45. Just we can write 45 by 90 is equal to g by 100. Okay, here 45 table, here it is 2 times. Okay, we can write Greek cross multiplication, then 2z is equal to 100. We want g is equal to 100 by 2. 100 by 2 means nothing but 50. That is 50 grades. 45 degrees is nothing but 50 grades. In the same way, we want to convert into radians means degrees and radians we want to convert. That means these two we can take. Okay, if they are given grades and we want to convert into radians means these two we can take. If they are given grades, we want to convert into degrees means we can take these two. Okay, according to the question we can go. And the next thing, in this only, the next thing is, length of arc, nothing but this one. One third. Here we are taking the radius. This is also radius. Okay, for example, if you are taking the unit circle means radius is 1, nothing but radius is 1. This is also radius, nothing but 1. Okay, when we can count as this is radian means this arc length also 1 means this is radius 1. If the angle is increased, arc of length also increase. Again, angle is increased, arc of length also increase. That means angle and arc of length are proportional to each other. Angle and arc of length are proportional to each other. For example, if the angle is theta, this angle total is theta. For example, this is 1 radian. Okay, here radius is 1. Radius r means here also length of arc is 1. Okay, if the angle is some theta, how much length of arc means we don't know, let it be L. Okay, by proportionality, what we can say? Here the angle is 1 radian and another one is theta, which is equal to, yeah, 1 radian means radius is r only, that is nothing but length of arc is r only, na? Radius 1, this is also radius only. Na? Next, length is L. By taking cross multiplication, L is equal to theta r, that means length of arc is equal to theta r. What is theta here means, once observe, here we are taking radian, this is also nothing but radian. L is equal to theta r, where theta is in radian system. Okay. The same way, we want to find the area of the sector. For example, some angle they are given, we want to find the area of sector, means area of sector. That is nothing but, here it is, some angle theta is given. Okay. This is radius r, this is r. And we want to find the area of this sector. Okay, how we can find means, for area of sector we have a formula, that is half LR. What is L means? Length of arc. Just now we find length of arc is equal to theta R. Okay, length of arc is equal to theta R into R. That is nothing but half theta R square, square units. This is area of sector. Okay. For example, clock. For example, minutes hand of a clock length is 7 centimeter. And how much length it will be traveled at the tip in a 10 minutes. Nothing but length of arc. This is nothing but length of arc they are asking. Okay, when, how we can find the length of arc means, when you know the radius and angle between the radius, we know means we can find the length of arc. How we can say means, length of arc is equal to r theta, we know the formula. Here we know the radius and we want to find the angle. How we can find the angle means, just here once of the, for example, we can go with hour ways. Okay, when 12 hours completed means 360 degrees over. That means each hour is how much angle means 360 degrees divided by 12. 360 degrees divided by 12. That is nothing but 30 degrees. That means 1 hour means 30 degrees. 2 hour means 60 degrees. That is nothing but, just here once of the, when you go with minutes hand, 5 minutes means nothing but 30 degrees. 10 minutes means 60 degrees. This is nothing but 60 degrees. 60 degrees. 60 degrees we are converting to radian system. 60 degrees we are converting to radian system. How we can convert into radian system? By using three system of relations we can convert, or we want to convert into radian system. Okay, 60 degrees means we have a shortcut. What is that means? We know pi radians is equal to 180 degrees. We want to convert into radian. That means pi radians by 180 is equal to 1 degree only. Na? We want to convert into 60 degrees only. Na? 60 degrees can be written as 60 into 1 degree. We can write 1 degree is nothing but 60 into pi by 180. Pi by 180 is nothing but pi by 3 radians. We got it. 60 degrees is equal to pi by 3 radians. We want to find the length of how much tip it will be moved, minutes hand how much tip it will be moved means radius is equal to 7 and angle is pi by 3 radians. That means length of arc is equal to L 7 into pi means 22 by 7 into here it is 1 by 3. Okay, 7 cancel. L is equal to 22 by 3. 22 by 3 means 7 times 21. Okay, 1 remainder. Okay, that is not usable. Then we can take a 0.1. 1 means 7.3 approximately. It will be 7.3 approximately. In the same way, we want to find the area of this sector. How much area it covers, the minutes hand covers. How much area the minutes hand covers means area is equal to what we can write means half LR means half into length of arc what we are getting approximately 7.3 into radius is 7. When you simplify this one means we are getting the answer area of sector square units. That is nothing but 7.3 into 7 means 7.3 is 7 3s are 21, 7 7s are 49, 49 plus 1 51, that means 51.1, 51.1 by 2, 51.1 by 2 means 25.5 approximately square units. That means area covered by the minutes hand. How much area covered by the minutes hand means 25.5 square unit square centimeter square. Why? Because here it is centimeter square. That means square centimeters square centimeter approximately. Thank you.